While nearly every one of Donald Trump's cabinet picks are awful in their own unique way, we do have a pair of new nominees that actually have something in common, a couple things actually. And so here we're talking about Kelly Loeffler and David Perdue. So Kelly Loeffler is being nominated to be the head of the Small Business Administration, David Perdue to be US ambassador to China. And as I said, they have some stuff in common. So, and I don't even just mean like generally, like they're rich. Obviously Donald Trump is not going to share a room for 5 seconds with someone who isn't fabulously wealthy. That's clear. No, they both basically lost their positions in the Senate due to insider trading scandals. During the initial days of the COVID pandemic, they used the privileged information they had to make tons of money while publicly advising all of you and your families that nah, nothing's gonna be bad, it's gonna be totally fine. You shouldn't benefit in the same way that we are. And the other thing they have in common is as a result of those scandals, they were kicked out of the Senate, delivering in Georgia two Democratic senators. It was an amazing midterm special election cycle as a result of that. But despite the fact that they had these massive scandals, and despite the fact that in basically a purple state, kind of historically a red state, the voters were like, we don't want anything to do with them. He's putting them back into positions of authority. And I want to give you an idea of just how bad their insider trading was. Perdue, during one single Senate term, made over 2,500 stock trades. And in particular, he purchased about a little bit more than $250,000 worth of Pfizer stock between February 26th and 28th, obviously in the beginning of COVID and the market downturn as people were getting scared. On the 28th, he issued a news release reporting that he had regularly attended briefings led by the coronavirus task force. Records subsequently showed that he had bought a third group of Pfizer shares that same day. So this dude is going and meeting with the people who are planning for the pandemic and then going off and buying tons of stock in the companies that will end up making money as a result of medication and vaccines and all of that. Loeffler, by the way, she barely waited. She was 3 weeks in the Senate when she attended a private Senate briefing by Dr. Anthony Fauci. Afterwards, she continued to publicly downplay the risk from the virus and its economic impact, implying that it's not going to be serious, everybody's going to be fine. But in the 3 weeks following that meeting, her and her husband made more than 20 stock sales between $1.25 million and more than $3 million, including buying stock in companies that produce teleworking software. Almost as if she knew that people were going to be working from home for a long time, but that's not what she was telling her constituents or the American people at large. And so the idea that they would be returned to positions of power after like trying to scam the American people, already making bank off of it and then being kicked out seems absurd. But Brett, what do you think?
I mean, the first thing is Trump is appointing losers to major positions in the government.
Also true.
Big winner guy. I like winners. I like people who weren't captured. He's like, oh, who are two undeniable losers? Let me put them in positions of power. Okay. You don't get that. Someone, does the guy even speak Chinese? I don't know. Is he, he's the ambassador to China, which is insane. So that's one thing. The other thing is it is insane to me and should be insane to you that people in Congress are allowed to buy and sell individual stocks. I always think they should be in an America fund. And if America does well, they get a nice little bonus structure. Because if I have a job and we're hitting all our targets, that's how I get paid more. These guys, they get paid more by using insider information about the inner workings of government than you and I have zero access to. And worse, they know what legislation's in the works and they know the likelihood that it'll be passed or not. They know which people in Congress are saying, all right, this is what we're gonna do and make it seem like it's gonna not pass because that person needs to be able to sit out because he's losing his race or whatever. But at the very least, we all know the thing that that makes us lose confidence in American institutions is stuff like this. And yeah. Donald Trump, who is the guy who said he was going to drain the swamp, has just put the two biggest loseriest swamp creatures in cushy positions that will benefit them more. Putting Loeffler in charge of the Small Business Council, the fact that she has corruptly taken insider information and profited off that. Who's to say she's not going to corruptly give handouts to people who scratch her back?
Yeah.
No one knows, but that's not helping this specter of corruption in America that we all fear and fear through actions like this are absolutely not specters, but real true monsters.
She is massive. She's worth $1.1 billion. And I believe, producer Ashley, her husband was the CEO of the stock market. That's what we were saying.
So funny.
And they're in charge of the Small Business Administration. What the hell do you know about that? You don't put a person who only consorts with elephants in charge of beetles. That doesn't make any sense. It's a different world. They need different things. But I love it as a symbol because it has always been true that when Republicans talk about small business, they don't mean what you think they mean. They're just talking about big business. That's all they're talking about, but they know they're not supposed to say that. And so, of course, you pick someone worth more than $1 billion to be put in charge of that. You know what you put in charge of the Small Business Administration? If you're the populist that you've pretended to be for years, you put some gym owner whose gym got shut down during the pandemic, and so he started going on Fox News. Put him in charge. I don't want you to put him in charge. But that's who you would put in charge because he's a small businessman. He understands what these damn libs in government have done. No, when you hand it over to Kelly Loeffler, who's literally tied to the head of the stock market, this is such a sham of populism. They are 100% creations of the machine, and Donald Trump serves the machine.
Right. And I've made inroads talking to small business owners about that very thing, because America thinks they're just a bunch of temporarily inconvenienced billionaires. And there's this false assumption that every small business owner has the same problems as a major corporation owner, right? That I'm a CEO, he's a CEO, she's a CEO, we're all CEOs here. But the fact is that the large corporations are the ones who have had exit velocity. And it's just like, you know how like there's an episode of Sopranos about how like all the super big celebrities just get more free stuff?
Yeah.
That's what it's like to be Kelly Loeffler. And you, as the owner of Joe's gym, you don't get that free stuff. And there is a way for the Democrats to seize on that and say they're the party of the little guy. Whether you're an employee, you're a member of a union, whether you own a small business, it's the corruption stupid, our way to power again.
100%. Yeah. I just want to read a comment from Aunt B, who says, when I worked at McDonald's, our friends and family weren't allowed to play the Monopoly game. You peeled off the cups. Why the hell can they buy stocks?
That's funny.
100% right. I love that, especially as an example, because that game was always rigged anyway. It's not like the family members, the employees were going to win it. Yep. It's so ridiculous. They should be locked up. Loeffler should be in prison for what she did. Perdue should be in prison for what he did. Regular small business owners should be able to visit the prison to point through the bars and laugh at them for what they did. Instead, they're going to be given government positions and salaries. Ridiculous. When you click the join button and become a tier 2 member, you get access to all of our weekly top 10 lists. What are you waiting for?